Welcome to Vegas Live with Ninon. Thank you for tuning in and enjoy the show. Well, welcome back again to Vegas Live with Ninon. I'm Ninon, your host. And you know, I just love my guests because majority of guests, I really don't know any of them. I've never met them before. But this particular guest, Jessica Mozingo. Am I saying that right? Mozingo.
That was close. Mozingo.
Oh, Mozingo. Excuse me. Mozingo. Yes. I'm giving you a little bit of a French accent in there.
Yes. I get
a little exciting. Now, Jessica, I was at an event down at a place that used to be called The Mansion, and now it's called Mansion 55.
It was Mansion 54.
Mansion 54. I always get a number wrong. See, I always go up instead of down. Tally-ho the fox. Anyway, and we were there on a big thing with Bert, and he was introducing different things. Well, what was the main object, and what was he trying to promote there, Jessica?
So we were there working an event for Demon Rum, which is a brand new rum company out, and Bert had us walking around, making sure
skimpy everything.
We were not dressed like this. Completely, yeah, we were in very, very skimpy outfits, walking
and
around.
And Bert was running around after you, and when I walked in, I said, where's Bert? And I looked over, and I saw you, and another girl, and I said, oh, typical, he's with the girls, he's not going to come and say hello to me, because I'm fully dressed.
Absolutely.
There's nothing to really look at, you know? I just thought that was so funny, but that's Bert, you know, he's a great guy, by the way. So you two were just sort of moving around. You were just sort of, you know, presenting yourselves or presenting the rum. I think you had the rum name on you.
We had the rum shirts on and just kind of entertaining, talking to people, promoting the rum.
Yeah.
But so you and I started talking.
But with my curiosity of life, because I'm always curious as to why people do things and why they get into it and where are they going. And I looked at her because I thought, wow, she's so beautiful. She's got a gorgeous figure and she's got all this going for her and she's just walking around here. Like, you know, I said, well, is this what you do? And she then you explain
that I had worked in bottle service for 8 years. I've been in Vegas for 10.
Now, bottle service means bartender.
Yes, serving bottles in the club. I worked in Aria Casino and Bellagio Casino as well.
Just the top, but I'm not surprised.
So you and I, we had a great conversation, and you said something that really struck to me. You
what did
said,
I say?
There's got to be more to life than walking around half naked.
But you say yes. That sounds like something I would say.
Yes, but it really struck a chord with me. It really did.
Well, only because you were kind of, you know, you can judge somebody whether they're intelligent or not, how they answer, you know, but you didn't. She was very upbeat and very. But what I did find out, and this is the tragedy with all these jobs, as you say, bottle jobs, whatever you're in, bartenders, waitress, whatever you're in, the industry jobs that you have. The problem is that you get so used to making so much money every week. This is the problem. They don't get $2 tips.
No. I was walking with my rent every single Sunday night. Like you're walking.
And she's rent, which is $1,200.
Which is $12, $13, $14, $15
And she would make that just in a Sunday night.
In one night.
So then you turn around, and I'm not saying it's selling your soul, but it's certainly selling
absolutely
the ability you have to maybe do something else, but you don't get as much money. And this is what I was trying to put to you. And I said, why would you be doing this? You're so beautiful. You know, and as I said, there's more to life than just...
There is, and it's tough. Yeah. It's definitely tough because that's what we were kind of talking about. You come here, and a lot of girls are beautiful and smart. And even for myself, I said, I'm only going to do bottle service for 2 years, and I stayed in it for eight.
8 years,
because
isn't it?
The money, just like you were talking about, the money's every night.
But now I'm going to ask you another question. And this is going to be really a personal question, but I'm quite sure you'll answer. How much money have you saved in the 8 years?
Well... there was a point where I had about like $20,000-$25,000 in my savings, like just looking at it in my account. And then, of course, the pandemic and being out of
work.
Which was a good thing, but you spend it so fast because you're getting it so fast. And that's what we talked about. Like you come back the next night and the money's there again.
You know that if you spend that $1,000, you know you're coming back tomorrow night and I'm going to have another $1,000 to spend or for the rent or whatever. So we have this problem of this money. It does buy you everything, which it does. I'm not against having money. I've always worked for money. I've never done what you've done, though.
Right.
But I did do modeling.
Right.
I did modeling.
Right.
So,
absolutely.
You know, runways and all this different stuff. I didn't walk around half naked. Well, maybe, I don't know. Maybe in bikinis it's half naked. What do I know?
Right,
You know, but I always had clothes on. But I'm
sure right.
One way or another, there was something on there.
Something on. Right. Yeah.
I was.
Absolutely.
And so, but then you look at the end of the 8 years.
Right.
What have you got to prove what you did? Because right. my philosophy would be, mm-hmm. if you've got all that money coming in, so let me mm-hmm. save $100,000. Mm-hmm. And the reason I know this, because I did it when right. I was 16 years old. Mm-hmm. I worked 20 hours a day, mm-hmm. 7 days a week. I only had 4 hours a night at sleep. Mm-hmm. But I had two jobs. And I saved mm-hmm. £100. And those, I could say in those days, but that's dating
right.
me. Mm-hmm. We got past that.
Right.
But in those days, that was enough money to get me out of where I was mm-hmm. to London mm-hmm. to do my modeling, to buy mm-hmm. to buy. So I had a plan. Mm-hmm. So I didn't spend the money I earned.
Right.
But you did.
Right. Absolutely. And so have all of my friends. It's crazy.
So what is the meaning of it? Just to live those, and then you don't get a guy because he's not good enough. Mm-hmm. And then you don't get a guy because he's not mm-hmm. spending enough money on you. Then mm-hmm. you don't get a guy because he's not paying the rent and your doctor mm-hmm. and this. And then you get a guy, I'm moving in with you because I love you and mm-hmm. you all want love. So they mm-hmm. all move in and then they get the girl to pay for everything. She doesn't mind because I got all this money and I'll keep you.
Right. Absolutely.
Did I nail that right?
Absolutely. It's crazy.
But it's true.
It is. But it's true. And then
definitely Vegas.
And at the end of it,
at the end of it,
you have experiences, but you're like, what do I do now?
What have I achieved?
How do I go work at a desk for 10 hours a day when I used to go to work for 4 hours in a nightclub?
Don't think that, but have fun all night. Because you've got
right.
all the guys cheering you, you've got them paying you.
Right.
I mean, you feel like a prima donna out there.
Absolutely.
Who wants to change that?
And flip-flop. And for me, I'm a people person. I want to be in the action. Like for me to just sit and be stuck all day long, that's just not for me.
All right, so we've gone through this little mm-hmm. sort of little whirlwind of what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
So after what I said, and after now you've come on the show, because mm-hmm. obviously she's come on the show because mm-hmm. she wants to learn some more things.
Yes.
So
yes.
So what are we gonna do with you?
Right.
Jessica, what are we gonna do with you?
Absolutely.
Because that's what this mm-hmm. show is all about. Mm-hmm. My show is all about helping people get mm-hmm. out there and mm-hmm. do something. So what has gone through your mind that you feel that you could maybe not earn as much money, but what could you do that eventually will take care of more money than you ever could wish for?
There's still a large part of me. I was actually talking with the guys before I came on here. There's a large part of me that wanted to do entertainment reporting. That was what I studied in college. But I think the problem that a lot of my generation is having, you find a good job and you apply and you don't hear back. There's 100 applicants.
So what?
I think you just get discouraged. You know,
if you really want to get discouraged, mm-hmm. take up modeling.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, you're right.
Believe me, I can tell you. You walk in 10 jobs, mm-hmm. you might get one. You mm-hmm. walk in 20 jobs, you might not get any.
Mm-hmm. And
you might
you
walk in and you say, oh, you're just what I want. Mm-hmm. And that sort of builds you up for the next one. And you slowly build mm-hmm. your rapport up. You slowly build up your friends. Mm-hmm. You slowly build up your modeling career. Mm-hmm. But believe me, you are turned down. But you learn to ignore that. You know that mm-hmm. they've got some crazy person in their mind
mm-hmm.
that's got, you know, bright red hair one mm-hmm. side and pink the other. Mm-hmm. And you happen to walk in as a very pure blonde, you know. Mm-hmm. And you're like, yeah, I got what we want.
Absolutely. 100%. Absolutely.
So it's not the effect. It's not. So mm-hmm. I learned you never take it personally. It's not mm-hmm. because I walked in the room and I don't look good. Mm-hmm. It has nothing to do with that. It's what they visualize, and you can walk in the door. Well, I remember I did a commercial. I forget 555 mm-hmm. cigarettes. I think it was in Beirut, and I walked into this door and they said, oh, "Perfect." And nobody else. They all went for the audition. Of course, they didn't get mm-hmm. it. So mm-hmm. imagine how they all felt.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So you've got to change that.
Okay.
But I think what you need to do, you need to find out first what you want to do and how you want to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And you need to have a direction mm-hmm. and you need to have a plan. Mm-hmm. You can't just get a microphone and get a guy and start filming.
Right.
You've got to have a plan.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a plan? Well, you went to college for this. You should know something.
I went to college for it. And I think just how we were talking about it just gets put on the back burner. And then you're kind of like in this muddy place. Like, where do I start? What do I do?
Well, you start with a single step.
Mm-hmm.
You start with maybe, I know you have to get licenses or sometimes. I remember everybody was just saying, you need to get a license to film in Beverly Hills. I said, listen, the time they come along and the time they want to write me a ticket, I'm gone.
Right. Absolutely.
So I never ever worried about that too much. I don't think they worried about it. Nobody really worries about it. But I know here they're very strict. But you can always get that permit. You can always get. So these are the things you need to do. But you've got the figure.
Thank you.
You've got the look.
Sweet. Thank you.
I love it. Look at these boots.
My boots, guys. Look.
My boots.
Wait
a second. Look.
My Pomeranian socks.
I'm undressing now. Look at the socks. Look at them.
I like to match. Yeah.
How cool is that?
Right. You're right.
You've got the ingredients. So now get it together. Money. When you go to work for somebody, always remember you don't get paid at the beginning of the month.
Right.
You get paid at the end of the month to prove what you've done, whereas your job is a little different.
You're getting paid at the end of the evening, you give a drink, they give you the money right away.
So you have to plan all these things. I don't think you should give up what you're doing right now, but what I do think is you've got to get into your system that I need to save this money. We just went through the pandemic,
right?
You had 25,000.
Right.
She was able to get through it.
Right.
Thank God you had the 25.
Still here. Exactly. Yes. Still
so
here.
So if you've got some still money over, I would start saving it. But I wouldn't spend it. You don't need anything. You've got probably loads of clothes at home, I would imagine.
Too many that I'm quite sure
you do. You're that type. Like, oh, I'm going to have this and this.
Too many. Yes. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Jessica's so much fun.
This is where my buddy went.
This is where my buddy went. But you have the looks, you have the personality, you have everything. And then now you've got to figure out, what am I going to do journalism on?
Right.
Am I going to do it in the streets? Am I going to do it in the casinos? Because they're all opening up.
Am I going to do it in the studio?
I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't do it in a studio with you. I would probably call myself Jessica the Streetwalker. Something like that.
Okay.
I don't know the name, but Jessica's walking the streets. Which might not sound too good, but it's got a little twist around it. Well, who's Jessica walking the streets?
What's she doing?
And I can help. It's a click that they'll say, well, and then that takes them to the page, to where you are. So you've got to line up your YouTube. You've got to line up your Instagram.
And get it going. And you're right. I have so much knowledge on Vegas, on things to do. A lot of people write me, where should I stay? What should I do? I want to go where you go when you're not at work.
Absolutely.
So I'm like, I can help people.
Hey, listen, I just got a phone call. I got a phone call from Iowa, wherever. Now, they want to know where they're going to stay in a hotel now. I'm going to go over to the hotel I've recommended some. And you go over, get into the manager, ask the manager, can I take a couple of photographs or can I take a little interview with you of your hotel and everything and send it back to these people?
I love that.
And he might even pay you for that.
I love that. See?
I'm giving all my secrets away.
See? She's helping me out.
Absolutely. That's what we do. That's what we do.
I love it.
So now we've got you organized that you're going to start doing something. So you're on the right track.
Absolutely.
How can they reach you?
I am on social media. My first and last name. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Instagram. Jessica Mozingo. You can find me.
Jessica Mozingo. M-O-Z-I-N-G-O.
That's a fun last name, isn't it? Mozingo.
Mozingo. I love it.
Yes.
So they can reach you there. And you don't have to give your phone number out. And I wouldn't give your phone number out.
Okay.
Because she's too pretty to give her phone. She'll never get to work. Right. Who is this? Oh.
Right. There's a lot of good people. A lot of creepers.
There's a lot of creepers.
There's a lot of creepers
out
too.
There, believe me.
Yes.
But reach you by an email. They can do an email.
Oh, I do have an email. Yes, it's mozi517@gmail.com.
There we go. So, Jessica, I hope we've helped you.
You have. Really meeting you, it was great. You struck a chord with me, and you are so worldly and so sophisticated and fabulous. And I was like, I just want to just talk to her and see what she has to say to me.
Absolutely. But you can't do it. No one's going to do it for you.
Mm-hmm.
Don't rely on anybody out there. There's a lot of wonderful people out there. There's a lot of people that will say they'll do this, and they won't. I've been through that.
Absolutely.
And you say, oh, thank you very much. Always be polite. Always be nice. And either they will follow up or they won't follow up. But Jessica's been an inspiration to the younger generation. I did a show for many years for the younger generation to help them get where they are. Everybody has a gift. She has a gift. She has a gift of beauty, knowledge. She's got a great personality.
Thank you so much. Thank
Maybe
you.
She'll take my job. That would be cool. We'll be right back with our next guest. Take care.
Bye.
If you enjoyed the last show we just did and all the other shows, don't forget to subscribe Vegas Live with Ninon on YouTube. We've got plenty more coming up and our guests are amazing. So don't forget to subscribe. We'll be right back. Vegas Live with Ninon.